Good morning. So here's the intro to the playlist for today. We'll be looking at digitizing, and then you'll be doing a little vector overlay on your own, or in lab. And we'll be doing this in quantum. The case is going to be mapping the Windfall Orchard, where if you go to this link, this is a local orchard. You might be familiar with it. It's at the farmers market. This is based on a project that Ben was working on this weekend. I thought it would be, we're basically going to be making a map and in the next several playlists kind of developing a database for this fellow who owns and manages the orchard. And I thought it would be a good case for a couple of reasons. It's relatively simple, and it's very, and it's, I think, going to be representative of a lot of kinds of projects you would do for clients. We're going to be using a shapefile, which you're used to, but we're also going to be using a KMZ file, which is a Google Earth file. And I've put copies of these two files on both the courses folder and the midfiles folder, so you should be able to just copy the week 10 part 2 folder. I should just mention this, the mid files, this is going to be easier for you to access from your computers if you're using quantum on your laptops at this point. It's in the share folder. Be sure that you copied it. I don't think I've actually put all of these folders there. I think some of these might have come from you, which is, just be careful about where you're saving your work, but go ahead and copy that part 2 folder and paste it on your working directory somewhere. So you can go ahead and open up the Windfall Plantings KMZ, and that should open up Google Earth. And it's going to load that KMZ into my places, which will also be your places. And it'll zoom right into this sparkling orchard in Cornwall. So let me just make this so that it fits. Bring this over, and then I'm just going to go into tools options, and I've got my vertical exaggeration at 2.25, and we can kind of look at this orchard. There's campus, so here I am looking back towards Middlebury and towards campus, and I believe, and here's the orchard that we're going to be looking at. And so one of the reasons to use Google Earth is when you're working with a client who has a lot of local geographic knowledge, but not a lot of technical knowledge, Google Earth is a nice interface for them to capture the geographic data from these types of people. Because the interface is so simple, right? You're largely using your mouse. It's really easy to add pins for the locations, and it stores it all in your My Places. And so it's, as long as you have internet, and I hope in your life you work for someone who has a lot of local geographic knowledge who doesn't have access to the internet. But in cases when you do have access to the internet, Google Earth is a nice kind of starting point to capture data. And so we're going to be starting with this KMZ. We're going to be doing these four tasks, and I'm going to take you through these through in the videos, and then this one you're going to do on your own in the lab, on your own in the sense that we'll be there in case you get stuck. So the first task that you're going to do is to capture a scalable image from Google Satellite Image, and this will be done in QGIS. You're going to be using a couple of tools here to do this, and the main concept are the idea of raster tiles, which is how Google Earth or Google's satellite image comes delivered, and their scalability. So I'm not going to have a separate video for this just yet, but I'll talk about these concepts in this video. After that, you're going to make a binary layer of the orchard trees. So you're going to take the KML, you're going to take the KMZ file and save it as a KML, and then you're going to convert the KML into a shapefile, and then you're going to do some vector magic. And this is the concept that I'll talk about there. And then you're going to digitize. You're going to create a new shapefile, and you're going to create features in it. And I'll go through these pieces in this one. And it's mostly going to be about air photo interpretation, is the maybe the new concepts. But you'll also have to learn a little bit about creating shapefiles or creating data in shapefiles, which you've done already in Arc, and you'll just be doing it in Quantum. And then the last one is you'll make a categorical map from the binary layers. I'm not going to show you how to do this because I think you'll be able to figure it out on your own because you know conceptually how to do it based on your work in Arc, and you're largely using the vector overlay operations. Okay, so there it is, and let's get moving on to task 1.